Test, 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 one, two, three. All right, so with level six, we are talking all about trigonometric functions. So we're talking about wave equations. And before we do that, we are going to be actually talking about angles and their measures so that we can actually work with sine, cosine, and tangent, because those graphs are all about knowing certain angles on a circle. All right. So let's start with some key vocabulary here. And you might take this for granted, but a lot of people get confused by these terms. So when we're talking about angles and their measures, we always have, so what we're going to be looking at is an angle starts at a vertex. We call this side right here the initial side. Angle starts on. This symbol means angle. If you didn't know, it just looks like this. So that's the shorthand that I'll use for angle. So the initial side is the side that we start on. The terminal side is the side the angle ends on. So if you're thinking about in a circle, we can either go clockwise and measure an angle, or we can go counterclockwise. So if we go, just so our terminology is right, if we go counterclockwise, we call that positive. And if we go clockwise from our initial side, we call that a negative angle. So, and you can have an angle that actually goes past, if we spin in a more than a full circle, you can actually go past your initial side, and that would be an angle that's over 360 degrees. So standard position is where we say the vertex is at the origin and the initial side is along the positive x-axis. So just looking at these two pictures right here, we consider these to be in standard position because the angle has a vertex at the center, initial side is along the x, and our terminal side, the side that we end on, is somewhere else. So we are going counterclockwise to get to this side, and that would be our angle measure in between. Likewise, we have our initial side here, we have our terminal side here, the vertex is at the origin, and this angle goes clockwise. So if we go clockwise, we're negative. If we go counterclockwise, so I'm just going to put clockwise and counterclockwise, positive. Clockwise is going to be a negative angle. So these are just the choices in which we use to describe angle measurements at the using an XY coordinate plane. Okay, so let's see. To draw an angle that's 45 degrees. So I'm going to start with the XY coordinate plane for each one of these and put it in standard form, so standard position. So 3, 4. So our initial side for each one of these will be along the positive x-axis. So it's sometimes hard to see the initial side. So let's do this in purple. 45 degrees. That means we want to go halfway towards 90. And we go from the initial side to the terminal side. We call this 45 degrees. To get negative 90, let's see if I can get a color that you can see. We go a full 90 degrees here clockwise. So we say this is negative 90 degrees. 225 degrees, we start from the initial side and we go 180 and then 45 more gets us to 225. So from here to here, we call this 225 degree angle because it's over 180. Lastly, 405 degrees, we start with the initial side and we're going to go around 360 So that's a full circle. We get back to our initial side. And then we need to go 45 more degrees. And if we go 45 more degrees, we get this angle. So this we would call 405 degrees in standard position. Now if you'll notice, 45 and 405 are the exact same spot, only 405 we went around one time. This is the big concept with things that revolve in circles, is our angles add up really quickly. All right, the second thing that people struggle with is there are two different ways we can describe angle measurements. One is in decimals, and the other, which is a more nautical measurement, so if you are ever on a boat or trying to judge where things are, sometimes angle measurements are given by degrees, minutes, and seconds. So the big thing is, if we're talking about degrees, that's one revolution, that's 360 degrees. Breaking down 1 degree, just like in time, 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. And 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So this double hash mark or double tick mark means seconds. So we can have a decimal and we can break that down into degrees, minutes, and seconds, or vice versa, we can have degrees, minutes, and seconds, and we can convert that to a decimal. So that's what we're gonna do on the next page. All right, so example two, it says convert 56 degrees, 6 minutes, and 21 seconds into a decimal. And this is the easiest way to do it. You take 56, that stays. Plus, we have 60 minutes, 6 minutes. So that's 6 over, well, there's 60 minutes in a degree. So we're doing a little unit conversion. So 6 over 60 plus 21 over, well, if there is 60 degrees in 1 minute and there's 60 minutes in 1 degree, there is 60 times 60 seconds in 1 degree. This is just a little bit of unit conversion. So 60 times 60 is 3600. So if you're wondering, if we take 6 over 60, this is our minutes. So let's write this. And 21 over 3600 would be our seconds. So now we just go to a calculator. You can use your phone, or I'm just going to use my calculator here. I'm going to hit menu, add a new calculator. I'm going to do 56 plus 6 divided by 60 plus 21 divided by 3600. And if I enter, I get a fraction. If I can control enter, I get 56.105, which I'll round up to 4 decimals, 1058. So my answer here is 56.1058 degrees. If we wanted to go backwards, we're going to separate this into pieces. So we have 21.256 degrees. So I'm going to take the 21 degrees part, and then I'm going to do 0.256. Well, in order to figure this, if we do a little unit conversion, there's 60 minutes in 1 degree. So if this is degrees, and I wanted to do a little unit conversion, well, I want 1 degree is 60 minutes. So I'm going to multiply this by 60. So I have 21 plus 0.256 times 60. So if I do that on my calculator, which I'm not going to show you, 0.256 times 60 gives 15.36. So that's 21 degrees, 15.36 minutes. Well, we want it in degrees, minutes, and seconds. So again, we take this decimal. We're going to do 0.36 minutes. And there's 60 seconds for 1 minute. So this means we're going to take 0.36 and multiply it by 60. So if we do 0.36 and multiply it by 60, we get 21.6. So this is 21.6. So we're just going to call that 20 to the nearest second. So that's 22 seconds. So what we did was we took this decimal, took the decimal portion, 2.256, multiply it by 60. We get our new thing, 15.36. We took that decimal again. So we took this decimal and we convert it into seconds. So our final answer is 21 degrees, 15 minutes, and 22 seconds. The other way of measuring angles, you might have seen before, is a measurement called radians. And you might be saying, well, degrees, I've always talked about this, it makes perfect sense. Well, degrees starts getting hard to count once you start spinning around more than two or three times. So if you spun around in a circle, that's 360 degrees. If you spun around a circle a second time, that would be 720. Third time, you get 1080. But if you spun around a circle 15 times, that's a lot of degrees. So instead of always having to worry about those really large numbers, anything that spins around, we use this measurement called radians. So radians is, to measure one full revolution of a circle, we just say it's 2 pi, because to find the circumference of a circle, it's 2 pi r. And our unit circle that we use, we say is 1 radian. So in order to measure this, to go around a full circle, is 2 pi, or 6.5, or 6.28 for a full circle. And so then we just take this into account, and it scales up no matter what size the radius is. It's always just going to be 2 pi to get around. So on the next page, we're going to work a little more of that. The other thing that we like to bring up once we introduce radians is arc length. So arc length is measuring, let's say on a circle, you want to measure the crust of a pizza. So if you're measuring just the crust, you take the radius times the angle in radians. So must be in radians in order to use this arc length formula. So S just stands for arc length. And oftentimes S is used as a measure of distance. And this is what we do. So it says find the arc length of a circle of radius 2 and a central angle of 0.25 radians. So we have a circle. The radius is 2 and the central angle is 0.25 radians. So I wrote that really small, but 2.25 radians. And we're looking for, how long is this arc on this circle? So we go S equals the radius 2 times 0.25. Well, 0.25 is another way of saying 1/4. So S equals 1/2 meters radians. So once we get to meter radians, if this is a measurement, well, we never say it's meters degrees. So this just gives us our piece. So we say this is 1/2 or half a meter is the arc length, because we need 4 half meters to get our full circumference. All right, let's flip it over. So the last thing that we should start getting familiar with when we're working with degrees and radians is how do we convert back and forth between one. So the easiest way is say, okay, for a full circle, it takes 360 degrees or 2 pi. Or a simpler way, for every 180 degrees, that is pi radians. So 1 degree is pi over 180 radians, or 1 radian is 180 divided by pi. These are reciprocals of one another. And this is just doing unit conversion. So if we have 60 degrees and we want to figure out what it is in radians, we do 60 times pi over 180. Because our degrees will cancel, and we're left with everything in terms of pi. So 6 divided by 18 is 1/3, so this is pi over 3. How about 150? This is going to be 150 times pi over 180, which is just 15 over 18 pi. So 15 pi over 18, but you can all figure that out. Simplify that fraction, that's 5 pi over 6. We always want to be in lowest terms. With negative 45, that would be negative 45, the negative stays, degrees times pi over 180. So this is negative pi over 4. 90 degrees would be 90 degrees times pi over 180, or pi over 2. And if we have 107 degrees, we have 107 degrees times pi over 180 degrees. And I do not believe you can simplify that. Just jump to the calculator real quick. 17 over 180. We get 107 pi over 180. Now, if we wanted to convert that to a decimal, we're just going to leave it like that. Keep your answers exact. So, example 5, going in reverse. If we have pi over 6 and we want to convert it to degrees, it's going to be 180 over pi. And the pi's will always cancel out. So 180 divided by 6 is 30. So this is 30 degrees. Same thing. 3 pi over 2 times 180 over pi. The pi's cancel. 3 halves of 180 is 180 plus 90, so that's 270 degrees. 7 pi over 3 times 180 over pi. Pi's cancel. 180 divided by 3 is 60. 60 times 7 is 42. So 420 degrees. Lastly, 3 radians. 3 radians times 180 over pi. So here, we don't have a nice way of doing that. So I'm going to do 3 times 180, enter. And then I'm going to hit divided by. And if you see this question mark on your calculator, this is where you should be able to get to pi. Sorry. If you see this, let me escape out of that. If you see this button right here, right over the comma, that's where you're going to get pi. If you type that in, we get 540 over pi. If you hit enter, we get 54.71 degrees. Lastly, finding the area of a sector. This is a fancy way of saying find the area of a pizza. So what we do, area formula for a circle is pi r squared. So in order to use radians, again, our angle measure is in radians, we're going to use 1/2 r squared times theta. And theta, this little thing, is a Greek letter called theta, which we use for angle measures, is our angle in radians. So find the area of the sector of a circle of radius 2 feet formed by the angle of 30 degrees. So first off, we need 30 degrees to radians. So that's 30 times pi over 180. So that is pi over 6. Okay, now this is our angle in terms of pi. Now we can do the setup. So the area formula equals 1/2 r squared times theta. Well, r is 2, so area equals 1/2 2 squared times pi over 6. So 2 squared is 4, 1/2 of 4 is 2. So area, so this is 2 times pi over 6, which is pi over 3. And since it asks to the nearest two decimals, we're going to go to our calculator. We're going to hit pi divided by 3, hit control, enter, and I get 1.05 meters squared. All right, this is our beginning talk about angles. Next up, we're going to talk about the unit circle before we get into our trig functions.